Okay. So when the king says, "Wait a moment," a few lines above, everybody was sure that the king would accept the ultimatum and sign the document. But when he says, "Wait a moment," there is a sudden silence of mistrust. That is, they don't know what he's trying to do, Proteus. So there is a catch in it, is there? That is, you have something up your sleeve. So Magnus, not exactly a catch. So Magnus says, it's not exactly a catch, but you have driven me. Means you have forced me, compelled me to face the fact that I am unfitted to be a constitutional monarch. That is, I am not suitable to be a king in name only. I am by nature incapable of the necessary self-effacement. Self-effacement means doing away. In other words, considering myself as unimportant. I don't have that capacity in me, Amanda. Well, that's true at all events. You and I are a pair, sir. That is, we are the same. So, Magnus, thank you. Therefore, while accepting your constitutional principle without the slightest reserve, means hesitation. That is, I accept the question of the constitutional head without any hesitation, but I cannot sign your ultimatum because by doing so, I should be making personal promises which I know I should break. I am not the type to act or rather to be treated as an India rubber stamp all the time. So I will break my promise, which in fact I must break because I have forces within me which your constitutional limits cannot hold in check. That is, I have elements in me, in my nature, in my character, which even your constitutional limits cannot control. Balbus, how can you accept our principle if you don't sign the ultimatum? Without signing, how can you accept it? So Magnus says, oh, there's no difficulty about that. When an honest man finds himself incapable, means unfit of discharging the duties of a public post, he resigns. So, when a man who's honest and he finds that he is not fit to perform his duties well, discharging the duties means perform his duties well, then what does he do? He resigns. So Proteus, alarmed, resigns. What are you driving at? That is, what are you trying to say? What do you mean? And Crassus, a king cannot resign. So Nicobar, you might as well talk of beheading yourself. You cannot behead yourself. Beheading means cutting your head off. A king cannot cut his head off. What are you talking about? Boanerges, other people can though. That is, other people can cut off even the king's head. It has happened in France during the French Revolution. Magnus says, do not let us quarrel about words. Gentlemen, I cannot resign, but I can abdicate. Abdicate means leave the throne, give up the throne, no longer be king. All the rest starting to their feet. Abdicate? They stare at him in consternation. Consternation means shock, disbelief, troubled look. Amanda whistling a descending minor scale very expressively, and she sits down. Magnus, of course, abdicate. Lysistrata, you have been a teacher of history. You can assure your colleagues that there is nothing unprecedented in an abdication. In other words, the Emperor Charles V, for instance, what he means to say is, it has happened before a king has given up the throne in the past also. And Lysistrata can tell you this. There are many such examples in history books. So Lysistrata, oh, Charles the Fifth, be bothered. Means, let him go to hell. He's not good enough. Sir, I have stood by you as far as I dared. Don't throw me over. You must not abdicate. And she sits down distressed. Throw me over means? Don't leave me alone like this. I have supported you as much as I could. As much I had the courage to support you. And she's very troubled. Proteus, you cannot abdicate except by my advice. He's a prime minister. So, only when I, the prime minister of England, says so, or allows you to, or advises you to do so. Proteus, Magnus, I am acting upon your advice. So, I am doing exactly as you said. Proteus, nonsense. He sits down. Balbus, ridiculous. Pliny, you are not serious, you know. Nicobar, you can't upset the apple cart like this. Now I hope you understand the title of the word, the apple cart. Jab falon ke thele par apples ka dher ho, aur koi us thele ko palat de, to kya hoga? Apples gir jayengi aur sari dishaon mein roll karke phail jayengi. So yahan par, now what is the apple cart? Cart, thela kaun sa hai? And Magnus is upsetting the cart. I must not playing fairly. He is not weak. He cannot be. I not have done with this superstition of. Superstition means the blind. A constitutional monarchy ka concept rakha. It powers in. America for ek tantra ban jana. I am abdicating to save the monarchy. Usko bachane ke liye. Not to destroy it. Monarchy ka matlab hai rule of one. I am trying to save it, not to do away with it, not to destroy it. In other words, what does he mean? Aage bata rahe hain wo. I shall be succeeded by my son Robert, an admirable constitution monarch. In other words, I am leaving this position, my son. Don't be hard. He has plenty of brains. That is, he is intelligent. Don't make life so difficult for him. Oh, yes, yes. I did not mean that he is a non-entity. Non-entity means a person without any personality or somebody unimportant. Quite the contrary. In fact, I mean just the opposite. He is much cleverer than I am. He is far more clever than me. But I have never been able to induce him to take any interest in parliamentary politics. Induce him means make him take any interest in parliamentary politics. He prefers intellectual pursuits. Intellectual? He prefers reading and writing, etc. So Nicobar says, don't you believe it? He is up to his neck in business. He has many business ventures. Magnus, just so. He asks me why I waste my time with you here pretending to govern the country when it is really governed by Breakages Limited. It is the Breakages, that company Breakages Limited, which is running the government in England. And really, I hardly know how to answer him. That is, the government, the country is being controlled or ruled by Breakages Limited. And I don't know how to answer him. Why? Because what he says is true. Things are like that nowadays. My son says just the same. Lysistrata. Personally, I get on very well with the prince. But somehow, I do not feel that he is interested in, basically, in governing the Albus. He isn't. He won't interfere with you as long as you don't interfere with him. Just the right king for us. Not pig-headed. Means he is not stubborn. Not meddlesome, not interfering, thinks that nothing we do matters a rap, means not even a little. In other words, whatever is done by us is totally unimportant in his eyes. He has no regard or respect for us. What do you say, Joe? What do you have to say, Joe? So Proteus says, okay, after all, why not? All right, feel free to leave the throne. Let your son become the king. If your majesty is in earnest, means if you are serious, then go ahead. I assure you, I am very leave the throne. Proteus, well, I confess I did not see this turn of events. I admit that I did not expect this to happen, but I ought to have foreseen it. I should have anticipated it. What your majesty proposes is the straightforward, logical, intellectually honest solution of our difficulty. That is what you are saying is straightforward means direct, logical means sensible, and intellectually honest solution to our difficult situation. Consequently, as a result, it is the last solution expected in politics. Honest and direct, the intelligent people. But I reckoned without your majesty's character. That is, I forgot what you are, how you think. The more I think of it, the more clearly I can see that you are right, that you are taking the only course open to you. When Proteus says this, assumes that it will become easier for the situation only because his name is Robert, will I please? This is what he believes. Because then another, is he? In other words, agree to accept the king's resignation. What Pliny means to say is that either way it is unimportant, whoever is king. Boanerges. Now Boanerges may appear to be foolish, but actually he is very intelligent. The way you fellows scuttle back and forth from one mind to another whenever Joe holds up his finger is disgusting with speed. From this is a cabinet of sheep. Sheep? You are blind and you are foolish. The Prime Minister has to lift his finger of the cabinet. If you can, do it. Have you anything else to propose, to suggest? Do you have anything else to suggest? Means, is there anybody better than me to take the position or the post of the Prime Minister? So Boanerges says, I don't know that I have on the spur of the moment. That is, right now, I cannot suggest anybody. But we should have noticed all this. We should have had notice of this. In other words, prior information. It is too sudden. But I suppose the king must do as he thinks right. The king has sprung a surprise on us. But then he is within his right to do as he pleases. Proteus, that's all right. Here the goat is out. Nicobar, if you come to that, who are you calling sheep? So Amanda, steady there, children. Steady. Hold on to the king. You have brought us all around, sir, as usual. Means, made us think or behave as you wanted. Proteus, there is nothing more to be said. Amanda, that means another half an hour at least. So now, Proteus will make a speech for another half an hour. Proteus, woman, this is not the moment for your tomfooleries. Means for your foolish behavior, having fun. Proteus, impressively, Bill is right, Amanda. He rises and becomes the conventional House of Commons orator, the public speaker. All the ministers compose themselves to listen with grave attention as if in church. But Lysistrata is contemptuous and Amanda is amused. Okay, before Proteus continues, let us take a break here. We will go on in the next session. Thank you.